गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू योर EVS क्लास। टुडे वी विल रीड द चैप्टर 7 हाउसेस। दिस इज द रीडिंग सेशन 1। सो लेट अस बिगिन। व्हेन पीपल बिल्ड हाउसेस दे हैव अ फ्यू थिंग्स इन माइंड। फर्स्ट, द हाउस शुड प्रोटेक्ट देम फ्रॉम द रेन, कोल्ड, विंड एंड हीट। सेकेंड, the house should be strong and not break under storms. Third, the house should last and need to be repaired often. Fourth, the house should be well ventilated. In a well ventilated house, air can enter and move freely through the rooms. The best way of ventilating a house is to have a doors and windows facing each other. The rooms should get enough sunlight, large windows let in sunlight and air, which keeps the house bright, dry and germs free. The house should be well ventilated. In a well ventilated house, air can enter and move freely through the rooms. The best way of ventilating a house is to have doors and windows facing each other. The rooms should get enough sunlight, large windows, let in sunlight and air, which keeps the house bright, dry and germ-free. They also let people use sunlight to do their work. Forming on lights during the day wastes electricity. The houses should be built in such a way that it does not become damp. When water collects in any part of a house, the floor, ceiling or walls get damp. This makes them weak. Also, germs and insects breed in damp places. That is why people make the floors and roof of a house very carefully. The roof is made waterproof so that the rain water does not seep in. The floors of kitchens and bathrooms are made to slope so that water does not collect. The drainage of the house or the system that carries water away from it must be good. The drains carrying wastewater from a house must be covered. This does not let mosquitoes breed in them. Next page, architecture. How I am pronouncing it? Architecture. Architecture is the art of a building. An architect is a person who designs houses, offices, and so on. The kinds of buildings are different in different places. You can say Indian architecture is different from Russian architecture in many ways. Why people build different types of houses? There are many reasons why people build different types of houses in different places. Natural conditions. The first reason why people build different types of houses is the natural conditions of the place where they live. For example, people build houses with slanting roofs in places where it snows or rains a lot. This lets the snow or rain slide off the roof. If too much rain or snow collects on a roof, it can harm the roof. People who live in places which get flooded, that is filled with water, very often build their houses on poles or stilts. They use a ladder to reach the door of the house. Some people live in places which have earthquakes. They build houses with light materials so that people do not get badly hurt if houses collapse during an earthquake. See the next para. Available material. Another reason why houses are of different types is the kind of material that people can get easily. In hilly forested areas, people use a lot of wood to build houses. Wood also keeps the house warm. In places where stones like sandstones are common, people use stones to make their houses. A lot of houses in Rajasthan and the hilly regions of our country are built of stone. Available space. Earlier, when there was a lot of space, people made a spread out single story houses called bungalows. Now people make multi-storied apartment buildings to save space. This is more true of big towns and cities. So a space is another reason why houses are built differently. Many years ago, there were a lot of people who moved from place to place or were nomads. They made light temporary houses. Temporary means something that does not last, and permanent means something that lasts. Most of these were tents made from available material. In North America, people made teepees by stretching animal skin over a conical frame of branches. In Australia, people used animal skins, branches, and the bark of trees. In Asia, people made tents of cloth woven from sheep's wool or camel's hair. They also used the skin of animals. Circular tents made by nomads in Mongolia, Turkey, and Siberia are called yurts. Now, not many people live in tents anymore. Now see the next para. Cost. The cost of making a house is still another reason why houses are different. People who do not have much money make temporary or kaccha houses. Many such houses in our villages are built with bamboo, clay, and straw. A house of this kind with a roof of straw is called a thatched hut. In places where there are a lot of palm trees, people use palm leaves to thatch their houses. Those who can buy tiles cover their roofs with tiles. The overcrowded parts of towns and cities in which poor people live in their temporary houses are called slums. People in slums make houses out of loose bricks, bamboo, plastic sheets, metal sheets, tiles, and so on. Making a good, strong, permanent house, yani pakka house, costs money. Permanent houses these days are made with bricks, cement, steel, and so on. Cement is a powder made in factories by heating clay and limestone A mixture of cement, sand and water is used to join bricks. The foundation or base of a house is laid first by digging a huge hole in the ground. Bricks or big slabs of concrete are placed in this hole. Concrete is a mixture of cement, chips of stone and water. When it sets, it becomes hard like a stone. You cannot see the foundation of a house. It is under the ground. Bricks are laid over the foundation to make the walls of a house. Now what you have to do? You have to record at least 2 paragraphs and send to me on my personal WhatsApp number. Next day I will explain this chapter. Okay, thank you.